Flowcharts help you explain a process clearly through symbols and text. More than that, they give us the gist of a process flow in just a glance. Let's see how to create one in PowerPoint. Rod here, and welcome to Burn to Learn. Here we have our slide. First of all, we need to add shapes. The four basic shapes commonly used for flowcharts are the oval shape for the start and end of a process, the rectangle shape for steps in the process, a diamond for the decisions needed, an arrow to link all them together. Even though these shapes are commonly used for flowcharts, you can use whatever shape you want. In order to have them all align as you want, we will use the grid tool. Just right-click on the slide and click on Grid and Guides. Then click on the first two options so the grid appears on the slide. So let's go up to the Insert bar, and then click on Shapes and select the oval shape. Now back in the slide, we drag the shape as big as we want. Click on the shape and go up to the Format shape, and then click In Shape Outline. And let's change this one to No Outline, or maybe to a color we like. Here we can change the shape color on Shape Fill. Here we can try some colors and see what works best. Just down below Shape Effects, in the arrow icon in the lower corner, we have the Format Shape menu. In the second icon called Effects, we can add some cool visual effects to the shape, like shadow. If you change one parameter, all the others will change too. So we're going to adjust the transparency as we want, maybe 28% or less. Next, we add a text box to our shape. Go again to the Insert bar and select Add Text Box, or right there in the Home bar, go to the right and click on Text Box. Now write in the information you want to present. And then we can add the next shape. This time, it'll be the rectangle, where we repeat the previous steps. Go to Insert, Shapes, click on the rectangle. Don't forget to add a text box to it, and do it again, but with a diamond shape. Once the second box is ready, we will link the first shape to the second one. Go to Insert, Shapes, and select an arrow, and drag it just from the first shape to the other so the arrow sticks to the shape. Just copy and paste the shapes pressing Ctrl plus C and then Ctrl plus V. Once all the shapes are ready, you can select a group of shapes and move them around. Use the grid in the slide to align the flowchart to the center. We're going to change the background color. So go up to Designs, scroll over to the right, and click on Format Background. Then on the Displayable menu, go down to the bucket icon, click on it, and here you can choose the color you want for the background. This flowchart is ready. Looking for more tricks and tips on PowerPoint? Check out our series. Like and share this video, and subscribe for more.